Cyanobacteria, otherwise known to a lot of people as blue-green algae, have been around for millions of years. So they are ubiquitous around the planet. It just so happens that in lakes, when we add excess nutrients to lakes, there's certain types of cyanobacteria that bloom. And unfortunately, some of them are acutely toxic to both humans and wildlife, as well as our pets.
We have seen that the Great Lake system has harmful algal bloom that is due to cyanobacteria. Every lake system has their own ecosystem. And what we're trying to find is what particular nutrients leads to all harmful algal bloom in a particular lake system, whether it be Lake Erie or Lake Superior and Green Bay. So I go like almost every month in the summer to Green Bay. Right now, Green Bay has much of water coming from Fox River and also water from Lake Michigan. And we are believing that it's the Fox River that's bringing the loads of nutrients and making it a favorable environment for algal bloom.
We know a lot about blooms that occur in Lake Erie, for example, and we've done lots of studies on blooms that occur in Green Bay. Lake Superior is probably the last frontier where we would expect to see blooms of cyanobacteria. However, due to climate change, warming waters, and extreme storm events, we are seeing blooms for the first time, unprecedented, in Lake Superior. So we're trying to understand, compare and contrast, what are the drivers of blooms in these three systems.
And it has been in the room temperature, and we see there is some algal growth.
I think one of the exciting things about the project is replicating the same experiments with our collaborators at Bowling Green State University in Minnesota-Duluth. We're talking about 2 years of experimentation across seasons in three different water bodies.
So this is all the lake samples from three different lakes?
That's unprecedented. I don't think that that's been done before, or at least not very often. Harmful algal blooms affect more than just human health. They also affect things like our ability to produce clean, safe drinking water that's cheap. We have a large amount of work to do with farmers in America, with agriculture, to try and understand how we can stem the tide of nutrients, but yet still make food for the country.